Happy Wednesday, folks. How the heck is everybody this week? We are back in action here on the channel. I'm excited to talk about today's topic, which is an all-in commitment to your results, whatever those results may be. Weight loss, career success, money goals, etc. And when I say all in, what I mean is I am committed to my results no matter what. No matter the ups and downs, no matter what I need to do, no matter how long it takes. I am here, I am all in, and I am not leaving until I get what I came for. Consider it done. So good. So that's what I want to talk about. Because if you have a specific result that you want to create, or maybe you are thinking about enrolling in a class or coaching program, whatever, your level of commitment will directly determine the result you produce, which of course, your level of commitment is determined by the thought in your brain. In other words, if you want to know on a scale from 1 to 10, how committed you are to your desired result, just look at how you think about the result. So let's talk about it. Let's talk about the thoughts of an uncommitted person versus a committed person. And I'll start off by giving you an example of low commitment. About 9 months ago or so, somebody had messaged me on Instagram inquiring about my FYP course. Now, right off the bat, whenever we're inquiring about something, gathering more information, asking lots of questions, we are for sure not yet 100% committed, right? We're still in the space of, I'm deciding whether I'm really committed or not. That's not to say that we can't get to a hell yes eventually, but it's just good to know. So anyway, this person reaches out to me. I'm not going to read their message word for word, but here are just some key phrases. They say, can you send me more information? I'm still unsure. What's your refund policy? I might give it a go. Okay, so he ended up enrolling in my FYP course, but I knew as a coach that he was gonna end up quitting. I knew he was going to ask for a refund. I literally left his investment in my PayPal account and did not transfer it to my bank. That is how certain I was. Long story short, not to my surprise, he asked for a refund. And I think he had only completed, it was like 33% of the program. Anyway, how did I know? How did I know he'd wind up quitting? I knew because of his lack of commitment, right? Thoughts of an uncommitted person sound like, I'll try it out. I'll give it a go. I'll see how it goes. This might work, this may not. It's this very laxed way of going about the result we want. And when we have laxed thoughts, it drives laxed action. That's when we just like dip our toe into the water instead of diving in. Or we just consume information, but we don't apply it. Or we kind of show up here and there, but not consistently. It's when we go through the motions. But then guess what? Our laxed thoughts create laxed results every single time. Because when we aren't certain about the result and instead we lead with doubt, what our brains do is they seek evidence to prove why it won't work, why your efforts won't work, why your actions aren't working, why this strategy isn't working, why this program won't work. So you want to be aware of when you're taking action toward a goal, but you really aren't that committed. You want to be aware of when you're relying on the action, the program, the class, the teacher, the coach to create the results for you and to overcompensate for your lack of commitment. It's kind of what that person in the example I just gave was doing. He was like, I don't believe in myself enough to produce results. So let me inquire more about your program to see if it can work for me. And then when it doesn't work, we then use it as more evidence as to why it's just not possible. when the reality is it's not that it's not possible or that it can't work for you, but rather you're not taking responsibility for your level of commitment and going all in. Make sense? Guys, the truth is there's no strategy that will make up for a lack of belief. Okay? There's no strategy that will make up for a lack of belief. In other words, you can sign up for Joe's 7-step strategy to turn your Etsy store into a full-time business in 30 days, but if you're going in with, I don't know, I mean, I want my Etsy store to be a success, but this goal feels really hard. I don't know if this is gonna work, but it's worth a shot. If you're approaching your goal with those thoughts, you will 100% prove that true and come up short. When we start out with disbelief in ourselves and low probability of achieving what we want, we are already setting ourselves up to fail. We've already convinced ourselves on some level that this isn't going to work. So now let's flip the coin and talk about what a highly committed person thinks. I'll use my own example. I've created a very big goal for myself this year, and I am very committed to this goal. And part of that all-in commitment for me was to join a new mastermind program to help me in the achievement of this goal. So anyway, there was a gap, like a 5-week gap from the time I enrolled in the program to when it actually started. So in the interim, I continued to build my belief in the result that I want to create and in the program. Thoughts like, it's already done. This is 110% going to work. I will get results. I'm here for all of it. Not just some things, but for all of it. I will not stop until I get what I came for. I am all in no matter what. The goal I set for myself in the mastermind is as good as done. It is all happening. No, these are just some of my own examples, but by developing that all-in mentality prior to tackling your goal and feeling the doneness of it with all of your being, what happens is your brain starts to support you in the creation of what you want. In other words, you will be led to inspired action. You'll be driven to show up constantly. You'll get to work. You'll continue to commit even when it doesn't look like you're making any progress. You'll keep on, keep on until you get the result you want. And so before the mastermind even started, I'm getting these inspired impulses of what to do to achieve my result. Like, I'm already making progress. I'm already getting my money's worth even before our first call. Now, sometimes making a monetary investment can fuel an all-in commitment naturally. For example, let's say you double down financially on your side hustle or invest in a high-ticket coaching program. I've done both, by the way. Sometimes, a lot of the time, that investment is enough, at least in the beginning, to feel all-in, especially if you're not used to putting skin in the game, right? You're like, shit, I just emptied my savings account for this. Hell yeah, I'm in. There's no other option here. Let's do this. But believe it or not, that too can wear off a little bit. Our brains get accustomed to monetary risks and get comfortable with just settling for less than we sought out. So in those times, it's equally important to continue practicing high quality thoughts around your result and the achievement of it. What can I think on purpose about the result I desire? How can I feel as though it's already a victory? Like, imagine a football coach revving his team up before the big game, right? Like, they're all huddled around and the coach is giving this high vibe pep talk and the players can feel it. They're like, yeah, yeah, this win is ours, right? They've already developed a certainty before stepping out onto the field. That way, they can get out there and perform at their highest level. That is what you want to do with your own brain in preparation of the result you want. All right, my friends, that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching per usual. Remember to give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment, and I'll see you next Wednesday. Bye.